sure you hold it. It's on the spring and it'll just... I don't have my steel toes on today. That's it, just comes right out. Like I said, don't lose the nuts or the bolts. Everything just slides out. That spring has a little bit of pressure on it. The end cap. This is the actual core. We're gonna have to remove this. We're gonna unscrew this. The whole core slides out. You drop in your new one, tighten it back out. Make sure you put your gaskets, new gaskets here, new gaskets on your end cap. Clean it up. There's a lot of dirt and stuff. Make sure you want to get it clean. That way you get a good seal. And that's pretty much all there's to it. I'll show you the whole process. Right. You want to get in there and clean all this here. All this. Make sure all that. Just pretty much take the dirt and grime off from inside. You want to put a new dryer. Want it nice and clean. This is pretty much what creates the seal right here. You don't have to worry about the outside. Once you open up your can, once you're completely ready, you open up. You don't want to expose it too much to the atmosphere, you know, to your outside. Once you're ready, they have this little, I don't know if you can see it, right here. You get some needle nose, or some pliers, or channel locks, whatever. You just start taking it apart and it'll slide right out. And the gaskets, everything's inside. And you just have to cut them out depending on your size. This guy. Just unscrew it. Oh wait. See that? There you go. That's it. I like to just clean this a little bit, give it a little wipe. Just to get all that dirt off. Nice and clean. This stays, this mesh right here. You don't gotta mess with any of this. It's another mesh strainer it has from the inside. See? Gasket. Gone. Alright, so yeah, just getting everything ready, giving it a nice clean before opening my dryer. And that's it. So you get this little key to give you with. And you can, either with the needle nose or this, I like to use the needle nose, it's a little faster, but this cuts it out pretty nice. You don't gotta be struggling with the needle nose. Sometimes you can pull it with the needle nose and it'll be a lot faster, but that's it. Yeah. There's your dryer. There's your gaskets. There's really no particular way. It's identical both sides, so just drop it in there. Drop it in there. Oh, I lost it. Just kidding. Oh yeah, where is it? Here it is. That's it. Just torque it back down and that's it. Center. Last torque. That's it tight. And before you throw this one away, before you throw the old one, what you can do is just, you know, measure it up to the new gaskets they provide. It might not be exactly the same, But it'll work. And then you just gotta just cut it out. Well, this not needed, so you know, just cut out what you don't need. Measure it twice. It's gonna be this guy right here. This is the one. Who's that? See, it's my new one. Put it on the end that goes into it. Just kind of how it was. Just try to follow it. You know, that's it. You guys can. That'll go in straight up. So that's for that one. That one's taken care of. Now you get your end plate, and they provide one for the end as well. Just measure it up. It can be the last one. All right, and you just carefully cut them out. You got your new gasket here. Don't want to rip it. Make you one. Now what I do is with the same key. That's why I was trying to take this off earlier. Same key they give you, I just press it in there. Bam. You might have to work a little bit because it was curled up in the can. I didn't put it in a foil, but it should work. That's it. It should create the seal. Yeah. Now the fun part, my favorite part, I'll show you guys right now. Alright, because space is a little cramped here, and I'm just kind of doing this by myself. It's a little harder unless you have somebody helping you push it up. Pretty much you just pop it back in place. Don't forget to put the spring, your end cap. I haven't found an easier way to do it. It's just the spring is going to push down on you, so what I like to do is I flip my bolt around just to hold it like that. Normally go the other way around, but I want to pick the nice spot. There you go. Doesn't matter. And just try to push it up. Try to get that first one in there. It'll somewhat hold it. And you can get another one on the other side. It'll be a little easier now. And shoot. Go. You just work your way around and put them. The reason why I flip the bolt around and put the nut at the bottom is, you know, I can sandwich it together and just kind of press it and just put my bolt like this. Otherwise, if it was the other way around, and this is the right way that, you know, should be, the nut is at the top, right? But as you're putting your bolt, you have to kind of, you kind of have to hold it in place and you know, spin it from the bottom, and hopefully it catches, which is a little let's see. As you're turning it, it'll hold. Once you get it started, the actual core, the shell will actually help you, you know, just tighten down the bolt, and it'll hold the nut in place. But just to get it started, it's easier for me to just sandwich it together and just put the nut at the bottom real quick. Then I come back around and flip it over. That's pretty much it. So, see that? Got one over here the same way. And then you can just come back around and flip it if you want. Once you get started, it'll hold it for you, so you know, you just might have to push it a little bit just to, that's pretty much it. Just go around, put them on, bada bing. Sporlan Bulletin says, torque these down to about 30 pounds. I don't have a torque wrench with me, so just gonna put them on pretty nice and snug. New gasket, everything should hold up. And we're gonna pressurize it and just double check and make sure there's no air leaking through these. I've had them where I put it on and I forgot it tightened one down and it's a little bit, you know, pressure coming out of it, so get a little leak. So just make sure you double check these while you don't fire up your system and, you know, a little leak. Sometimes if you torque it down a little bit more, it'll seal it up. And don't forget to put your gasket. That's a big one too. All right. It's only been a week. The rush of being home and rapid fading. The failing to recall what I was missing all that time in England. Alright, so that's pretty much it. Just go around, torque them down. You know, it's gonna be too tight. You got a gasket in there. It should seal it up pretty good. About 30 pounds. I don't have a torque wrench, like I said, but torque that one down already. Check that one, you know, the other dryer, and we're good. No little leak. Just clean it up afterwards. That's it. It's pretty much just ready to pressurize this circuit. This. Compressor one, and double check my connections, my brazing. I already got one vacuum running on the circuit two, compressor two, and yeah, pretty much it. So I'm ready to pressurize it. Like I said, double check it, spray some soap in there, do whatever you gotta do. Make sure you get no bubbles, nothing leaking. So, alright, thanks for watching.